Welcome to the program.
Hello, thank you for having me again.
You're very, I mean, I look at you, you're in control.
Opo, I think the whole family is po.
Because so, of your faith. But lahat kayo born again.
Opo, the whole family.
Okay, so, I know, medyo I'm pushing this. How are you coping?
We're doing okay. The family is doing okay. My dad's doing okay. So, I think we just really prepared ourselves for whatever because the case has been going on for 9 years. So, since it didn't end, we didn't want to put an end also to how we were preparing for whatever is to come.
Ah, so kahit anong mangyari, hinanda niyo mga sarili
yes.
niyo. Whether maganda yung outcome or itong outcome na to,
yes.
you always have that in mind.
Yes. And my dad also talked to me. So
how was that conversation?
Ano sabi
he
niya?
Said that the case isn't over yet. I'm proud of you that you're trying to provide for your family and you and your brother. So just be ready. Whatever God has for our family, we will accept it wholeheartedly.
You mean ikaw at yeah, si Marco?
It was me and my dad lang in the car.
Oh, pero yun, parang by providing for the family, yes. kasi kay ni Marco ang tumating yung breadwinner ngayon.
What did you have to go through? Kasi matagal yung kaso, hindi ba? What was the worst?
So the first few days.
Because ito, ngayon? Or
no,
yung noon-noon?
Back then.
The first few days because?
9 years ago
nine
ito.
9 years ago because we were there when it happened.
Ilan taong ka nun?
I was grade 6 po.
So mga 12?
Okay.
12, 11.
Naroon ka nung nangyari?
Yeah,
and then?
I was there when he was taken, so it was kind of traumatic for me and my sister. So it was hard coping with everything, with the media. It really blew up.
Did you understand? At grade 6?
At 11.
Yeah.
Medyo.
Medyo. I was already
may sinisisi ka? I mean,
wala naman
wala. Did you understand the case? Did you know the truth? By then, naikwento na ba ng tatay mo? I mean, you know, where were you?
I was always with my family. It was really my mom who held us together. And she was the one who explained everything, told us whatever was going on.
Kamusta siya ngayon?
She's very strong.
Okay. Oh, wow.
My mom
okay.
is very, very strong. And she's the one really holding our family together. Traveling from Quezon City to South all the time just to visit my dad. Because us siblings were busy with work, with school. So since she's a housewife, she always travels going to my dad.
At grade 6, meron bang nangahas na lukuhin kayo? Tanungin, I mean, did you go through...
Nabully ba kayo?
Oo, nabully ba kayo because of what had happened to your father?
Hindi naman po. The media was very respective, like what
school.
Happened recently.
Friends?
School?
Neighbors?
Of course. There were a lot of opinion that really came from the media, came from the public, and my mom just said to respect whatever they had to say because everybody is entitled to their own opinion one point or another.
Ang tatag ng mom mo talaga.
Hmm. She's very, very strong.
Anong pinagdadasal niyo ngayon?
Right now, just for security for my dad. That's the main point. And really for him to fulfill what God has in store for him. Because everybody siguro in our family is looking forward to whatever God has in store for him because of this big challenge. Of course, in the end, there will be a bigger blessing.
When was the last time you spoke to your dad?
I was with him last Sunday. The whole family was complete in Muntinlupa.
Did you have a conversation?
Not really. It's normal
nothing
na
like,
now.
Nothing like, you know, that time when you spoke to each other?
No, wala na. So okay. we just, bonding na lang talaga, like a normal day.